Hi everyone, Nick here. I just watched a video over at Mr. Excel on YouTube from Bill Jelen, and he created a video in which he showed how you can get how you can know if a cell in Excel contains a specific word. When you have a cell with multiple words or multiple values, can you, in another column or another cell, have Excel tell you whether or not a single word or single value is in that cell that combines multiple values? And I thought, oh, I could use this trick in analyzing data that I get from a Microsoft form in a survey. So if you do survey research, you're probably very familiar with the fact that we can use a select all that apply question or a multiple select question. So in this example here, it's a question, which of these fruits do you like best? And I'm going to send this out to my survey respondents, to my survey sample, and they will be able to select as many of the options as they want to. So we have blueberry, orange, strawberry, grape, banana, and then none of these. So that's a cool question. It's great. It's a great option when you have responses that people will probably want to select more than one. The problem with Google Forms and Microsoft Forms is that when you export these data into Excel, all of the values that they select come into one column. And so here's what that looks like. When I export this data from Microsoft Forms, this is what it looks like. The ID column is my survey respondent. So I have 20 survey respondents. And then this is how they responded. Each of them responded to that question. So survey respondent number one said that they like blueberry, strawberry, and orange. Now I can't really do very much with this data in Excel to analyze it. I could make a pivot table and I could kind of summarize these data and see how many people from this sample selected blueberry, strawberry, and orange, or how many people selected blueberry and banana, like this second one, but it's not going to tell me how many of my respondents selected each individual option. So the way that you need to set that up in order to do it, it needs to look something like this, so that survey question exports so that each column is its own response from the survey question. So in this case, I'm saying a single column will be for blueberry, a single column will be for orange, a single column will be for strawberry, etc. And then the ones and zeros just mean if it's a one, that person selected that response, and if it's a zero, they did not select that response. And if you're familiar with using more sophisticated survey apps like SurveyMonkey or Alchemer or Qualtrics, this is really how they export those types of questions. It makes it a lot easier to work with. And so by this, when you have it like this, you can easily sum down the columns, and then I can see how many people from my sample selected each of those. So all I would do in order to do that was just down here, type a quick formula here, a sum formula, and then drag that all the way down, close the parentheses, and now I can see that 8 people selected blueberry. I can drag that across to copy the formula here, and then if I wanted to do percentages, I could do another formula right here, equals, I'm going to point to number 8, and then I'm going to divide by 20, because 20 is the number of people that I have in my sample. So I'm just going to click on that, and then I'm going to drag this over, and then I'm going to make sure that these are formatted as percentages, and now I have some data that I can really work with. So 40% of people selected blueberry, 25% of people in my sample selected orange, etc. So if I go over to forms here, this is still how it's going to export, and I need to transform this data in some way. So using the trick that I learned from Mr. Excel's video, I can actually do this right from the Microsoft export. So the Microsoft form export in Excel. So this is how it would export in Excel. I still have all of my survey response data all in one single column, but then I'm going to go ahead and add a column in my spreadsheet here for each of the response options, and there's nothing here. We're going to put some formulas in here in a second. But the first thing I want to do for Microsoft Forms, they automatically export these things in dynamic Excel tables. And Excel tables can be super useful for a lot of different things, but in my case, for this survey data, I'm analyzing it one time. I exported it one time after the survey was finished. I don't need this table to be dynamic anymore, and in fact, it will mess me up when I'm trying to create some of the formulas and transform this data here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to convert this table to a range. So click anywhere in the table, and you can see the table design tab open right here. I'm going to click on that, and then over in the tools menu, I'm just going to say convert to range. When I convert this to range, I'm going to say yes. This takes away the Excel table, so now there's no dynamic table here. It's just a normal Excel spreadsheet right here. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually use a countif formula and just copy this formula. I'm going to put this in the show notes. So just copy this formula just like I'm doing it. I'm going to also use an absolute column reference and an absolute cell reference to this formula. It can get a little bit confusing, but just sort of hang with me here and go step by step. So in this blueberry column, what I want to know is if this cell here contains blueberry, I want this cell to say 1 so that I can easily analyze these data down the row. So what I'm going to do in this cell, C2 here, I'm going to start the formula, open with an equal sign. Then I'm going to say countif. We're going to use the countif formula, open your parentheses. I'm going to go ahead and click on this range right here. And I'm going to put a dollar sign before the B. And I'm going to click on here in the formula here. I'm going to push comma. Now the criteria, if this cell contains this cell. But before that, I need to create a few little extras beforehand because this cell doesn't just contain one word. It contains a bunch of different words. So what we're going to do here is put a quote and then a asterisk and then another quote. And then I'm going to put an ampersand. And then I'm going to point to this cell right here, my header, which is C1. And then what I'm going to do is right after the C, I'm going to put a dollar sign. That's an absolute column reference. I'm going to click back here, put a comma. Actually, I'm not going to do a comma. I'm just going to do a open quote and then an asterisk and then a close quote. And then I'm going to put a close parenthesis here. And what this formula is going to do is it's going to ask Excel if this cell contains what's in this cell, it's going to spit out a 1. So I'm going to go ahead and push enter. And there's a problem there. Let's see, what did I do wrong? Dun, 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 dun. It's going to tell me, oh, I know, because I need to do another ampersand. Okay, this is why. So I need to do another ampersand here. So it's and then and. Now I'm going to push enter, and it's going to be 1. Okay, so there's a little bit of problems there, but this is how these live demonstrations go, right? So that's a little bit of troubleshooting here. So your formula has to look exactly like this. Now, when I do this, since I set up those absolute references to the rows and columns by putting those dollar signs either before the B and then after the C, it's going to be responsive when I drag this across. So I'm going to go ahead and take my cursor, drag it across to copy the formula, and you can see it worked beautifully. So in this cell here for this respondent, they selected blueberry, strawberry, and orange. So in these cells here across the columns, we should have a 1 in blueberry, which we do, a 1 in orange, which we do, and a 1 in strawberry, which we do. The other should be 0 because this respondent did not select those responses, and that's perfect. Now, again, because I've set up those absolute cell references, I can copy this whole row here, and then I can drag it down to copy down, and it should work. So we can do a little bit of a check. Let's just pick this one down here, number 17, respondent 17. They picked blueberry and grape. So we should have a 1 for blueberry and a 1 for grape. And we do, and all the other ones are 0. Now I can go ahead and analyze these data perfectly. I'm just gonna go ahead and click auto sum. That's gonna sum the entire column. I'm gonna push enter. And again, we have these data. I'm gonna copy that over. And then what I'm gonna do is do that percentage calculation again, type in equal that cell, divide by 20. And we're going to format this like a percentage, and I'm going to drag that across. Now, if I wanted to put this in a really handy, convenient table, all I need to do is highlight my top row of headers here. I'm going to push the control button, and then I'm going to go down to my total and my percentage, and with the control button held down, I'm going to go ahead and select these all. I'm going to do control C to copy. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to paste special. So here in this cell right here, I'm going to right click and go to paste special and then transpose. I'm going to go to paste special and then I'm going to click on value and number formats and then click the little transpose button there. And that's going to make me a nice little summarized data table. So I'll click OK. And there we go. So I have my response options here, my count here, number of respondents who selected each response, and the percentages there. A really nice trick to deal with this issue in Microsoft Forms and Google Forms when they export select all that apply questions. If you like this video, I hope you'll give it a thumbs up. I was so excited to learn this trick and share it with you all. Remember, you don't need to be a professional designer or a data analyst to look like one using the tools that you already have. Excel and PowerPoint are super powerful tools. I hope you all have a great day, and I will see you next time.